Hello Virgos, welcome new viewers, cross watchers and my lovely lovely moonians. This is Gypsy and Moon. Thank you so much for being here. And for those who still have the birthdays, happy birthday. So September has been quite interesting. Moving forward, since we start this period with the full moon in Pisces, there's a lot of creativity stepping into your emotional realm, understanding your feelings, what to release to gain more balance and more control, gently disciplining life, what has been working, what has not been working. If you are interested on a day-to-day basis, energy or even astrology update, you may like to see my Instagram channel, because that's what we do, daily energy posts over there. So let's just begin now, because we have quite a few cards coming through. So firstly, we have Three of Crystals coming through. So this is really interesting. We have Three of Pentacles coming in reverse. This is saying that perhaps there has been certain kind of creative block which we need to overcome, or even certain kind of underestimation which is happening. There's a lot of blessings which are coming through, or even a lot of input from the spirit realm. But there's someone who is right now in the materialistic world who is being stagnated due to other materialistic worries perhaps, or the scope or the trajectory that you're going, kind of finding yourself in a vacuum at the moment. This is also talking about now is the time that you start discovering what is within your gifts and talents. That is what is coming in. There could be certain kind of great ideas which will be coming through or are already there in your mind, but you're not just, you haven't hit that point where you want to be like, yes, this is it. Perhaps it's asking you, the universe is asking you to clear your mind a little more. There may be too many things that you may be focusing upon at the moment, that it is kind of bifurcating your own energy, potential, capability. That is coming through over here very, very strongly. This is, of course, a general reading, so take what resonates, all right? So next card, we have Seven of Shells also coming in, the lobster coming through. So I suddenly, like with the lobster over here, it's like the clamping things together, or sometimes holding on to things which are too strong. Like even if one of them is getting, how do I say it, captured, they will try and attack, but at the end of it, they're attacking someone's finger or whatever, and in a way they're attaching themselves to this predator, that kind of a thing. I'm not saying someone's going to attack you, but just be aware of what is making you stop. Because this card over here, when Seven of Cups comes through, it talks about certain kind of unclear vision or procrastination that may be happening. Are we doubting ourselves too much that our talents are getting wasted during this procrastination time? Analysis paralysis? Yes, that is coming in. Or this is just asking you and telling you that you're getting extra amount of time to think things more clearly. Perhaps there is a bit of strategizing or planning which is further on required, whether for this idea, a talent, a serious hobby that can be turned into certain kind of entrepreneurship, that kind of a thing is coming in. What is really aligning with your life? This is a time of arts and creativity, and again the light is gone. Okay, so there's a lot of energy, which is why we didn't even do the Gayatri Mantra. So let's do it now. Let's align ourselves. Let's get into oneness with ourselves, with our inner voice. Your intuition is growing. Now is the time that your intuition will be urging you to go forward. So let's chant the Gayatri Mantra and bring in more peace and calmness in ourselves. All right? So just breathe in and breathe out, releasing any negative energy or doubt. Breathe in once again and breathe out. Om Bhur Bhuvasvah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Na Prachodayat. Daya. Shanti. Now, let's go forward. Alright, so the third card coming through is the Traveler coming in. Aquarian Major Arcana coming in reverse, the Fool card coming through, the Dreamer. This is also saying that there could be a new life trajectory or a new reality which is kind of daunting you, or this is also saying that you need not jump in. But if you find yourself procrastinating, now is the time that you need to realize that the opportunity, the window may get closed by the time you are ready. So be in the now, be here right now is the energy which is coming through. Let go of anxious thoughts. What is working for you? What is not working for you? Become aware of it. I do see over here in terms of another person that they may be resisting taking a next step because there's someone who needs to develop or become more confident in their feelings or who they are. That is what is coming in. There's a completion which is required before they can begin a new journey, which is why the zero is coming through over here. And in reverse, there's certain kind of stagnation coming through due to indecision or just this confidence, lack of confidence or lack of reason or the staunch motivational factor to go forward. That is also what is coming in. What is causing the stagnation? It's just that there are certain things which are stopping you from going forward, wherein the movement is like really going to, it's almost like if there is a stone over here and there are waves coming through again and again and again and again, what will happen is that this eventually the stone will start getting molded or softened through the edges, but the waves will keep on pushing and pushing, and the more the tide gets stronger, the bigger the waves and the splashes. So that is what is coming in. If you have been emotionally stagnant in a certain place or even in terms of a relationship, it will keep on coming in waves to you. Even if you push it, the more you push it, the more momentum you give to the thing, and it will keep on rising till the time you are kind of pent up, whether with this vigor to go forward or to speak up, to vent it out, whatever it is, that boiling point or that pinnacle point of moving forward. But first we need to end before we can begin. That is the thing which is coming through. There's a hop, skip, jump which is coming in, but we cannot hop till the time the second place is not clear to us. Where will we be landing? That kind of a thing is coming in terms of this person as well. They're not really confident as to where this is going in terms of a relationship too. All right. Or they are just too comfortable in their comfort zone. So the fourth card coming through is Queen of Acorns coming in reverse, which is kind of interesting. Queen of Acorns, Queen of Wands is coming in after a long time. But this is someone who is feeling a little irritable, is kind of being very irrational, impulsive too. Their behavior could be quite opposite from what they were. That is also what's coming in because they're trying to decipher things. They're trying to understand, kind of becoming impatient, kind of acting a little childish or in extreme. Sometimes they're happy, sometimes they're really blasting off or bloating things. It's kind of coming in as a surprise because there's someone who's going on and on in the same cycle, wanting a change. That is what is coming in. So they need to also become more clear of their inspirations, motivations, what are their understanding about love also, which is coming in. But there is certain kind of pent up frustration which is keeping them in one rut and is causing you to be kind of directly or indirectly be involved in that stagnant energy. Could be you or the other person too, but fire signs are in fact coming in. There's Aquarian which is coming through. There's a bit of Scorpion energy which is coming in. Certain kind of past that we need to release very, very strongly and forgive and forget kind of a thing, which is very important because the more we grip onto our hurt, the more we will be hurting ourselves and no one else. We need to let go because we have been engraving ourselves for too long. Release it for the skin also to bounce back to where it was originally. That kind of a thing is coming in. Let's move forward and see energetically what's coming through. What do we need to know energetically? for any kind of spiritual guidance that you will be benefited from. Lessons, blessings. Alright, that's way too many, but we'll rush through them because it's still kind of the Virgo season. So we have woman hold thinking, the thinking woman coming in reverse. Again, the procrastination energy is coming in. Now is the time that we start taking enough analysis. Divine feminine energy is coming in. Yes, we have been analyzing, trying to safeguard ourselves, but so much so that we've ended up with too many layers of blankets above ourselves. Instead of being out there in the open, confidently, kind of hiding ourselves is the thing which is coming through over here. Think more clearly, become your own visionary is also what is coming through. Open. When you're ready, the master will appear. That kind of energy is coming through. And we also have healer of the ages coming in. So it is very important. Before we can initiate in any direction, we need to change our own energy field. Even when we start loving ourselves, we change who we attract into our life. There's healing, which is very much, very, very much required, is what is coming through. So become aware. Tap into your emotional realm. We have man holding a coin coming through. So there could be certain kind of financial investments also which will be coming in. Instead of rushing into it, yes, it may be very, very beneficial. But first, we need to ground ourselves, become more clear, do thorough study about it, read the contract and all of that, and then make a decision. But financially, if there were any kind of constraints, they will be slowly and steadily going away. There could be a male who will be suggesting you a few things in terms of finances. You may like to take their advice. If not, act immediately, but take it into consideration. The next card, we have Archangel Camille also coming through. So it is coming in reverse. So there is perhaps for this person over here, because we have fire signs also coming in. Fire signs are Aries, Leo and Sagittarius. And this card coming in reverse is the solar plexus chakra being in reverse, or which needs to be realigned, because there's certain kind of blockage coming through. When we have too much energy also in the solar plexus chakra and it is not getting utilized or channeled in a proper way, there comes in with a lot of energy, fire within you there, because it's not getting utilized in the right way because of confusion or whatever it is, there comes in irritability, frustration, underconfidence also. Could be that since I was talking about divine feminine over here, divine masculine is coming in over here with this card reassuring the same energy, which is that someone may be too kind of held up to be impressing the world, or the worldly thing, that is what is coming in. Answerable to the world, that they're not really giving this relationship or even their own emotional side enough attention. That is what is coming through over here. So, and it's really interesting because the full moon in Pisces meditation, we have called upon Archangel Camille. So you may like to do that. Or if you want to realign your solar plexus chakra, I suppose the full moon in Sagittarius was about this. You will see it somewhere or the other. It would be written in the description box. Perhaps you can see it. You may like to do it. If this is that point, because we have a little bit of creativity which is not being tapped into also, which is the same energy of this card. And this one came in for Librans too. All right. So the next card coming through, we have Angel of Strength also coming in. If there is a Libran or you have Libra in your charts, perhaps more preferably your moon sign, you may like to read. See the Libran reading as well. So Angel of Strength is coming in. Again, Leo energy is coming through. Fortitude. Becoming the lion. Soaring and roaring. But not blurting or being rash. Being calculative. Knowing when to attack, kind of a thing. From being the prey to becoming the predator. That kind of a thing is what is coming in. Becoming more eager to go forward. This stance over here is this lion over here is almost like he is eyeing the prey. He's eyeing his prize. And this is that moment where he is becoming in that stance of plunging forward or running. So this is that preparation time is what is coming in. He is very focused over here. Let me just focus it for you guys so that you can at least see the eyes if possible. That is what is coming in. Becoming clear in your sight. Seeing that, like, it's almost like achievable. That kind of a thing is coming in. Become more sturdy. grounding yourself will be very beneficial. And the sun and all the planets which are there in Virgo itself, Mercury, Mars, and even Venus is in Virgo. So utilize the fire which is coming in, clarity of words, passion, do things gracefully. Anything that is disrespected or you feel disrespected in any kind of situation, make it known. Enough of taking it. It's now time to be shown into the world. That kind of a thing is coming in for someone who has been retreating for too long. We have adjacent possibilities also coming through. This is in fact saying perhaps there have been too many worries or too many things that have been holding you back, which is kind of restricting you from seeing everything. Even if you want to achieve certain things, perhaps if you feel that you have this urge of speaking out, blurting something to someone because they really need to hear it, there may be a different way of saying it in such a way that the other person too is open to listen to what you have to say. I do see that the same situation may be having many adjacent possibilities and you need to take a full picture. But if you have been trying to understand and keep on waiting and waiting and waiting, you need to know stagnating yourself will not really help anything, because the more you stay in a situation with where you feel hellbent on achieving something, getting fixated, it limits your scope to that. Or sometimes when we are too busy overly analyzing or overly thinking about things, we do tend to miss out of the opportunities which are going here and there. Even in terms of ideas, I'm not talking about people, but in terms of ideas as well. Keep your options open is what is coming in, or at least raise your eye point of view and see, look around. That is what is coming through. So lastly, let's see what's coming through over here. There's a lot of fours which are coming in. Stable. Next steps are pretty much vital. So think more clearly. So the last card coming through, we have B coming in, community coming through. You are a powerful creator. Your work blesses everything you touch. Be open to receiving sweetness. You are a queen, the queen of abundance. We have queen of abundance coming in over here, who is abundant in her energy, in her vibrancy. And now is the time that she starts believing, nurturing, appreciating who she really is, and not get stagnated or caught up in the web of worries. That is what is coming in, freeing yourself, working hard on your dreams. Sometimes we don't see the efforts being rewarded immediately. It is very important for you to have more strength and perseverance, determination, patience, in order to see whatever you're wishing for to come into fruition. That is what is coming in. Bees are hard workers as well. They work together. So could be that you may be collaborating with people also, like-minded people who will be coming in. Perhaps you meet someone romantically, platonically, or soul family-wise kind of a thing, soul tribe, vibing together. You both come together and that formulates that solid idea, unifies a very good idea to go ahead. Their talents, your talents mixed together, it's a bonanza kind of a thing which is coming in. Financially, yes, I do see that you are stepping up, and this will be a very nice time to become more sure of who you are, of what you're doing, what is working, what is not working. Becoming aware of it, becoming more in control of things, speaking up, being kind to yourself and others, but voicing your opinion too. Don't shy off from stepping on the stage is the energy which is coming in. If there are certain kind of creative talents that you have, utilize this time. This is going to be very, very, very good. There could be golden opportunities also coming in. All right, so be aware of your environment. Many, many good things are coming your way. Just raise your vibrations and see how that ripples and brings abundance in manifolds into your life. Alright, so that is what is coming through. Do let me know if this resonated. And if you enjoy this reading, then please do hit the thumbs up. And please do subscribe to the Moonian family. We're growing every day. Your opinions really do matter. And thank you so much for the love and support that is given to this channel. Until next time, many, many blessings, clarity, strength, viewpoints, insight, vision, patience, and determination to you all. Om Namah Shivaya. Keep that vibe high, my lovely moonians.